How you doing?
How you doing, John?
Good.
Good. How's college been? Good. Good. Are you a professor yet?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the John Ginsburg Gallery, Creative Center Players Main Stage. It's our pleasure to present for you this evening, Motive for Murder. At this time, we would ask you to silence or turn off any cell phones. Thank you while we wait for the past. Thank you very much. At this time, we would also ask that there would be no flash photography of this evening's presentation. And now, enjoy Motive for Murder.
Thank you.
Charleston, ragtime, blues, the age of jazz. Wow. Dancing and music filling the streets from America to Europe. The 1920s defined the time and its people. Silent pictures talk, and celebrities are now heard around the world. The war to end all wars was over, and the world was a lot smaller. Traditions and times were changing. Corruption flourished as prohibition strained America's tolerance. Suffrage and women's rights to vote illustrated the importance of women in all of society. The daily news was a powerful instrument to inform, influence, and even manipulate. Publications like the Pompous Tribune clearly stretched the boundaries of accurate and credible journalism. Eight perfect strangers assembled in Devonshire, England, to board the train headed for the mansion of Sir Winston Wadsworth. They have two things in common, to be free from the past and Sir Wadsworth. Included in their invitation to spend the weekend is a gold embossed promissory note entitling them to £250,000. Now, who in their right mind could pass up £250,000 in 1920s England? If they only knew what was ahead of them, perhaps they would have. Sir Wadsworth, Admiral of the HMS Nomad, lost his legs at the Battle of Bengay Chin Bay. He never fully accepted his forced retirement from the Admiralty. His influence and resentment have turned toward amassing a powerful empire from his newspaper. The Admiral has been blackmailing his eight guests for years. In part, he blames them for the loss of his legs. Then, why the reward? Our guests hope it will bring them freedom. For Wadsworth, however, his intentions are anything but benevolent. A dinner party, charades, entertainment provided by his guests, and a presentation of the awards are planned. There's a catch, however. The mansion will be secured, and no one will be allowed to leave. If they try, their award is forfeited, their dirty secrets exposed, and Scotland Yard will come and arrest them. Sounds like a motive for, do I dare say it, dirty tricks, pranks, short-sheeted beds? No, murder! Join us in our whodunit mystery, Motive for Murder. Airhead, teletype operator, worked for Sir Winston typing his notes and naval strategies. Her secret? Accused of selling secrets to the enemy. However, her typing was so bad, no one could understand her code, even the enemy. If found out, she would be imprisoned for selling military secrets, not to mention being fired for impersonating a secretary. Dr. Jonathan Butterworth, ship surgeon, attending physician when Sir Winston lost his legs. His secret, the Admiral wanted his legs mounted in his library. Butterworth lied and said they were lost. He's accused of stealing them and selling them on the black market as war memorabilia. If discovered, he would lose his physician's license, his military pension, and be imprisoned. Miss Mildred Maple, private investigator, traveling to her country home to relax, be with friends, and put up some homemade preserves. Her secret? Mysteriously dismissed from Scotland Yard. She's not being blackmailed. Dinny Starlet, actress. Butterworth's surgical nurse when Sir Winston was injured. Her dirty secret? The Admiral's legs were amputated because of septicemia and not sanitizing before surgery. She also had a baby out of wedlock, and if exposed, the publicity would ruin her career and be imprisoned for malpractice. Lance Boyle, entertainer, ladies' man, wireless operator on the HMS Nomad. His secret? Father wanted him to be a gangster like the rest of the family. He really wanted to be an entertainer, so he ran away and enlisted in the Navy. If ever found, we don't know what his family would do to him. Captain Odera Scotch, second in command on the HMS Nomad, the Admiral's flagship. His secret? He was supposed to be following orders. Instead, he was mocking the Admiral behind his back. He also liked to short shoot his
bed.
If ever found out, he would be charged with dereliction of duty, reckless endangerment of the fleet, an injury to the Admiral.
His court-martial
would mean imprisonment.
Have to see it.
Have to see it. And short shoot his bed for the rest of his life. Jeeves Leadfoot, butler and driver for Sir Winston, injured during the war and walks with a limp. His real name is Jeeves Leadbetter, but the Admiral likes to humiliate him and called him Leadfoot because of his injury. His secret? Shot himself in the foot and claimed he was wounded by enemy fire. If the ministry ever found out, he would lose his war medals and veteran's pension. Helena Schnapps, maid, married Jeeves Leadbetter, German espionage agent. Her secret? Defected to England and married Jeeves. If ever found out, the German police would arrest her and try her for treason. Sir Winston Wadsworth, Admiral of the HMS Nomad, a decorated war hero and knighted by the king himself. A battle injury causing the loss of his legs forced his retirement from the Admiralty. As a result, he's become bitter and vowed revenge on those who caused him so much pain. He is the owner of the Pompous Tribune and uses his fortune to exploit and crush anyone opposing him.
Hello, I'm Amelia Earhart.
I'm Sir.
Say what?
I haven't said it yet.
Said what yet?
Great Scott, what I'm going to say.
Well, say it.
I'm going to...
You're going where?
I'm not going anywhere.
Then why are we at the train station?
You misunderstand.
How can I? I don't know what you said.
Can we start again?
Hello, I'm Amelia Earhart.
Great Scott, not again.
Wait, do you have the time?
Yes.
What is it?
What's what?
The time. Great Scott, it's tea time. My work, so it is.
Hello.
What?
Why?
What?
Lies. Not quite. Makeup. Ugh. How uncouth.
Blimey, what's uncouth?
Hello, I'm Dr. Butterworth.
Do you drop things?
Not on purpose. Why?
Well, your name is Dr. Butterfingers.
That's Dr. Butterworth.
Say, Dr. Butterworth.
That's Butterworth. Butterworth.
Why? Do you move words?
I'm afraid not.
Afraid of blood?
No, I just don't do words.
Oh, you're too good, are you?
I don't do that kind of surgery.
Oh, the steam is messing up my hair.
Not you.
Makeup, makeup.
I'll be bored soon.
And you are?
I'm Order a Scotch.
Well, order me one too.
Makeup.
If you're ordering scotch, order me one too.
Make that two. No, three.
No, my good man. My name is Order a Scotch.
Wait. talking about bloody babes.
We'll have a smashing good time.
I say, you remind me of a patient I have.
Did we have wart?
Great Scott, not wart again.
German ladies, let's board.
I've been bored for the last hour.
By sitting on the board for an hour.
You don't know bored till you've sat through a medical lecture.
Was it on wart?
Great Scott, get off the wart.
Good man, I'm trying to get him off.
Separately and at different times. No one will know who is coming until it's too late.
Jeez, jeez, get the leg out. Oops, sorry.
The guests will be arriving soon.
Off the lever.
Tonight's the night.
Tonight?
Yes. We'll finally be rid of that monster.
Then what?
Then we can...
Yes, yes. Can, but...
We can...
Yes, yes. Tell me.
By jingo, we'll be free.
By jingo? That's it?
Schnapsy, dear. That's all we'll need.
Off the lever. I love it when you talk like that.
I'll get it.
But?
The front door.
Is it broken?
No, I'm answering the door.
But it's saying.
No, my rosebud. Someone's ringing.
That Liebchen, not rosebud.
Yes, dear. I mean, Liebchen.
That thing needs fixing.
I'll get it.
Ah, you must be Dr. Butterfingers.
That's Dr. Butterworth. How did you know?
You dropped your coat, hat, bag, watch?
Well, I know.
Yes, you did. I saw you.
Great Scott, I've never been so insulted.
Your room, Dr. Buttercups.
That's Worth. Butterworth.
Yes, sir. Dinner at 7. I'll get it.
Come in.
Hello, I'm ordering a scotch.
The bar is through there. You ordered the scotch.
No, that's my name.
Follow me, sir. Dinner at 7. I'll get it.
Strange. Doorbell.
Think of it as a reminder to go to the door.
Off the lever. Grand idea.
Please come in.
Hello, I'm Amelia Earhart.
You can say that again.
I'm Amelia Earhart.
You don't say.
I did?
Yes, you did.
What did I say?
You said, hello, I'm Amelia Earhart.
Yes, well, I'm Amelia Earhart too.
Fine. Airhead.
Who told you?
You did.
I did. Do we know each other?
That's enough, dear. Dinner at 7.
Hello. I'm Amelia Earhart.
Follow me, please.
That's one Looney Tune Legion.
Hope she doesn't get lost going to the loo. I'll get it.
Hello! important.
What?
Your name.
Oh, I'm Lost.
Hello, Miss Lost. I'm Snopsy.
I'm Milford Maple.
Are you Lost or Maple?
I'm Lost and Miss Maple.
Octa-lieber-lieption, we have a problem.
May I help you?
She skips a lieption.
Hello, I'm Miss Maple and I'm Lost.
See?
I'll handle it.
Is she always like that?
You have no idea.
I think I'm highly irregular.
I'll be most grateful.
Perhaps we can accommodate.
Thank you.
Follow me, please. Dinner at 7. I'll get it.
Hello, your buttership.
Good evening, sir.
Where are you hiding this shirt?
Next to my blouses in my closet. Fine.
Later, dear. Follow me, sir. Dinner at 7. I'll get it.
Good evening, Mom.
Oh, the lighting is all wrong.
Huh?
The stage lights.
For what?
My grand entrance.
Grand entrance?
Quite right.
Follow me, ma'am. Dinner at 7.
Octa-lieber. House full of loonies, Legion.
Set an extra plate for Miss Maple Lost Her Way.
Ring the bell.
Sounds like a Dory mine then.
Say, wouldn't you want the...
Ladies, I am here.
Oh, heavens. Not you again.
This is, well, I recognize, maybe...
Octa-lieber, that's a miracle.
Thank you.
For what?
What?
Excuse me. I'll give up oxygen. Pay no attention.
I couldn't pay anything anyway.
Snopsy.
Please, sit at your name flat.
A dinner is about to be served.
Oh, a dinner scene?
Makeup!
Well, I never. More makeup!
Quiet!
Jeeves, continue.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have promised a reward for anyone lasting the entire weekend with me. And for such a handsome sum, I have a few activities for your amusement. You may leave if you wish, but if you do, you will forfeit your reward and ever be rid of me. After dinner, we will retire to the ballroom, where each of you will provide some amusement for the rest.
What are you talking about?
Sir, I'm here by accident.
Oh, now she's this accident.
Accident?
What the devil? Come on.
Their house will soon be locked and will not reopen until midnight Sunday. I will make a call at precisely 12:01. But if it is not received, Scotland Yard will be notified, and 45 minutes later, they will arrive and haul all of you off to jail. And your sordid, dirty little pathetic secrets will be read in my Sunday morning edition. Ah!
My word, Great Scott! Quite disturbing.
Blimey!
We get to be in the paper?
This is bloody confusing.
Well, I think I should be leaving.
Step around.
Sir Winston Wadsworth, I've heard of you.
Nothing good, I hope.
Ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
Continue on.
I'm accused, after amputating the Admiral's legs, of selling them on the black market as war memorabilia. The enemy paid good money for proof of crippling an adversary. I'm guilty, and I deserve to be punished for my crime.
Your legs were so badly mangled, I had to dispose of them.
Move on.
Selling military secrets to the enemy. I hated being called an airhead and a loser. I liked stealing military secrets right under their noses. I'm guilty and deserve to be punished for my crime.
It's true, I think. What did he say? Would you repeat that?
Move on.
My secrets to Jeeves. I chose love over being a spy. I married Jeeves, but continued to send messages back to Berlin. Jeeves was a fool and never suspected I kept my cape, negligee, and spy glasses in the secret apartment. In my real name is Olda Schnitzel. I'm accused of being a fake wife, fake maid, fake defector with a fake German accent. I deserve to be punished for faking everyone out.
Is that true?
But
are you still a spy?
Oh, Legion, I love you.
That's it? That's it? You love me?
Sir Vincent is a snake groomer.
What's that?
Yiddish for big stinker.
By jingle, this mind reading is great.
We can do anything in the story.
Better hang up now, Lucian.
I was the Admiral's second in command. I'm accused of not following orders. Instead, I made funny faces behind this ship collided with another ship, causing injury to the Admiral. If the Admiralty found out, I would be hung from the highest yardarm. What's worse, I loved to short-sheet his men. Guilty of dereliction of duty, I deserve to be punished for my crimes.
It's true. I love to short-sheet his men.
Continue, Led Butt. I tried to be a he-man bloke, but it's all a shoe. My old man wanted me to take over the family business. Bootlegging, gun-running, gangster. I wanted to be an entertainer. I just love the spotlight. When the ship wrecked, I was on the wireless lining up engagements. I'm accused of using the ship for my own personal gains. I deserve to be punished for my crimes.
What a joke.
I am a better.
Prove it.
This is gonna be interesting.
To the ballroom.
Intentions of giving them away is not. After the last act, he plans to burn them and laugh his head off while they stare at their dreams going up in flames. He will remind them that if he doesn't call at midnight, Scotland Yard will arrive 45 minutes later and arrest anyone attempting to leave. The perfect end to his twisted sadistic plans.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your long awaited rewards, like I promised. After our entertainment, I will instruct Jeeves to give you what you deserve. I've placed them in full view so you can see I'm a man of my word. Let us continue the evening.
parasites enter the nostrils while sleeping, and the first stage is convulsion, followed by uncontrolled vomiting. Then it gets bad. Flesh-eating sores, oozing with yellowish pus, with the rotting fish bouquet emerge.
Bread pudding? Custard? What a gourmet, anyone? I'd like to recite a poem I learned as a child.
Well then.
What?
Your poem.
What poem?
The one you said you wanted to recite.
Which one?
We don't know. Pick one.
Okay. There once was a man from Nantucket. Oh.
Bravo! Bloody.
My turn. What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor early in the morning?
Jeeves, get the drinks and bring the plate while you get it. One more act.
And who? What's that?
Me. Jeeves, the candle.
What are you doing, Admiral?
There's a storm coming, so I'm lighting up your dreams.
What? You're not setting their checks on fire, are you? Why?
I made a promise to give them what they deserve.
Pardon me, Admiral. Our drinks.
Later. You're going to need a stiff drink after I'm finished.
Drinks, not the lights.
I'll take the light switch.
Under the clock, I'll knock the light switch.
Just swell. Now what?
Great Scott, what's now?
What?
Smashing carrot, eh?
What goes round? What comes and goes round? What?
Quick, get rid of the poison.
Wait, the phone call is almost full.
No one is to blame. They all thought of bumping him off.
Stop the yard and down with this.
What about the chefs?
Great Scott, he was going to burn them.
Quite. Who do they belong to?
Good heavens, food names are on them.
Ours.
Then they're legally yours.
By Chino, we got away with murder.
We got away with murder.
Blimey, we got away with murder.
Great Scott, we got away with murder.
Just swell. We got... What? What happened? Hello?
Bloody good. We got away with murder.
You're free to go. I'll handle Scotty Arch.
I'm so glad you lost your bay here. Miss Maple lost her bay.
How will you explain this?
I'm actually an undercover detective from Scotland Yard.
Miss Maple, we have a confession to make.
We plotted to kill him.
I know.
Well, so how is that possible?
I thought of it myself.
Why?
I lost my way on purpose.
So, you're not Miss Maple who lost her day accidentally?
Yes.
and no.
Miss Maple started as a young, ambitious Scotland Yard detective. She was assigned a case investigating Sir Wadsworth. When her investigation brought suspicion on him, she was suddenly dismissed. However, she continued to work for the Yard undercover as a defrocked, disenfranchised private investigator.
I'm sorry for the deception. I'm here to find evidence.
What?
Blackmail, and I found it.
That's funny. My mail is white.
It took years, but I discovered you folks been blackmailed.
What now, Miss Maple?
I see no evidence of foul play.
But we're guilty. Our motive was to kill him.
You have to deal with your conscience on that one.
How about the loot?
Wadsworth made a contract with you. You kept your part.
So it's really ours to keep?
What's your reward, Inspector? My reward, to finally catch the villain.
What's next?
I guess to put me back in the yard.
In the front yard? Or the back yard?
Three cheers, hey! Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Inspector, did he know you?
We never met. I was only a name on a long list of people to sign.
Scotch anyone?
Now you're talking.
I suggest you leave now, before the police arrive.
Yes.
I would say it was nice to meet you, but I would be lying.
Well, Crosby, Snowheads, open up seats under it.
No offense taken. Farewell.
Inspector Maple decided to take a closer look at the Admiral. She noticed something curious about his cape. Would you look at that? It appears his cape caught on. What is that? A nail? That's odd. How did that happen? At precisely that moment, his cape became entangled and strangled him? Well, it is an old house. Nails do come up from time to time. Or was it something else? It's just a coincidence. Or was it? The old screw. He had it coming sooner or later. We may never know if it was an accident or a murder.